And now here is our first guest, international superstar, with the role of Bella Swan in the beloved Twilight saga, the much-adapted second film, New Moon, hits the theaters this Friday, and please welcome Kristen Phillips.
Yeah, I mean, it takes me back like a month. Yeah. Actually, what am I saying? We made Eclipse, so 4.
Right, wow.
Yeah, her latest movie is the Joan Jett story, right? You played her?
I did.
Yeah. But she was the executive producer of the movie.
Well, that's the thing, is like, how do you play somebody that is standing right there and able to say, that's not how I did it. That's not how it was.
Yeah. Totally, but I think it would have been worse had she seen me once a week after seeing dailies and said, like, so, now that I can't do anything about it, she's become, like, one of my closest friends.
And, oh, that's and, nice.
Yeah, that's a great closest friend to have. Like, sure. I just adore Joan Jett.
Yeah.
I don't even know what I would do if I met her.
Did you have to audition for the job?
No, luckily I didn't have to actually, I told them straight up I wouldn't even know how to start because that's sort of presumptuous to say that you could kind of come in and,
yeah.
I had a meeting, I talked about it with them.
And you sang her songs live in the movie. Did you sing her songs or not?
I did.
Yeah,
not live. We pre-recorded them.
Oh, well, sure, that's what I mean. I'm sorry, I shouldn't have used that word.
She has a very specific sound. Mm. I mean,
yeah.
Did you try to mimic her voice or did you just sing as yourself?
I tried to mimic her voice.
Mm.
I tried. Now the movie's going to come out and be like, you tried to mimic her voice?
You're tired of that, aren't you? of course you try to mimic the voice or get sound as much as you can like her.
She has a very distinct growl.
So specific.
Yeah. And you had to cut your hair too, huh?
I did. I chopped it off.
What was that like?
It was crazy. It was getting almost, I mean, it was getting close to the Bella hair. It was getting close to that length.
Yeah.
Yeah. And the first thing they did, they took it up here and just chopped it off and left the length. It was like,
right.
Just like,
that short. And did you cry? Like I always do when I get a haircut?
No, I was so excited. I was amped.
How are you handling all this hysteria? This tumult about yourself and about the gang and the Twilight series and all that? Is it okay? Is it getting down? You know, you're all over the world now with this thing.
Yeah, we're busy. We're busy, thankfully. I mean,
but I, you know, everywhere you go, there's so many groups of screaming people following you. I've read that you can't leave your hotel room, which I would love because I love a hotel room. But do they put you? Do they put you in nice hotel rooms? Is it swanky at least?
It was nice. I mean, it was very corporate living is like. it worked. I mean, we worked our butts off on this. Like literally, we were the only time I was in my hotel room, I was sleeping. Seriously.
Mm-hmm.
So it was okay.
But now that the movie is released, now is when it all comes back to you. You know, right?
Yeah,
the crowds,
totally.
The applause, the screaming, the yelling.
It's definitely a different experience. The cool thing is that, like, I usually make movies that people don't see, and the only reason you do it is because it's true. Like, you do it to share it with people, and I'll never, I mean, this is a once in a while, this is exceptional. I mean, I'll never have this again, no matter what kind of movie I make, so, like.
Yeah, sure. All right, we'll take a break, we'll come back, and,
when we come back, Kristen tells us her pick, Robert Pattinson or Taylor Lautner.
Kristen Stewart here. You all know her from this Twilight series, and we're going now into the second phase of the Twilight series, second picture. So where does the story take us this time?
Well, the really sort of perfect love that we present in the first one is completely shattered. And you see this woman become a woman. I mean, she builds herself back up again from nothing, and I think that you need that in order to completely subject yourself to something so much greater than you, and blah blah blah. But my best friend is a werewolf and my boyfriend's a vampire, and they don't really like each other very much.
I don't know, but your best friend, but is there a love attraction between you and your best friend?
Yeah.
So in other words, these two guys are competing for Bella.
And see, Edward and Bella, like, Edward loves Bella, but he also wants to, like, You know, he's a vampire.
Of course
so
he
he's
is.
Got urges. You know what I'm saying?
I understand. But now they got a werewolf.
Jake has urges, too.
Yeah, well, okay.
I never met a werewolf
he's
who
like
didn't
a pack
have
of wolves,
urges.
That
yeah, that's
boy.
Right. So you've got to make a decision here, is that it?
Yeah, I mean, I like to think of it, though. It's not even a choice. It's like, it's sort of a... I mean, it's a different story because she's literally, like, physiologically completed by him. So that's why it's hard.
Right.
Because she actually discovers that there are different levels of loving someone, and it's not just this.
Do you understand that teenage girls, like, that have connected with your character, Bella, right now, try to pick fights with their boyfriends to make all of this sort of turmoil happen at home? But it really doesn't. It's not quite the same, is it, girls? It's just not. I'm reading their minds right now.
And doing very well,
thank
too.
Thank you very much.
I think it's your own mind, Ricky. But mentally and emotionally and psychically, who do you think is better for Bella? Is it the werewolf or the vampire?
It's sort of hard for me to say.
As Bella.
As the vampire.
The vampire.
Yeah,
yes,
I'm like so of that. Like,
vampire does it every time, I'm telling you. Yeah. And
who
what
doesn't
about,
like a vampire?
Now, what about Taylor? There's a lot of talk about him playing Jake. Might be replaced for this film, but he came in a bit bigger than ever, right?
Yeah.
Had a sort of a transformation.
Completely.
All the weights and all of that?
Yeah, I mean, he definitely put on a lot of weight, but, like, the only reason he was able to do that was because he was... I mean, he had the confidence before that. He already... It was so clear that he was the right...
He possessed that... what you need to play
yeah.
that role.
Yeah.
He had it in him.
Yeah, I mean, you needed such a strong character.
Mm-hmm.
I was so of the Twilight mind. I was like, I couldn't understand a story without Edward because that just doesn't make sense. Like,
mm-hmm.
you have to play that part.
Mm-hmm.
And so I was like, you better be, like, outstanding, dude. And he was honestly, like, the most fun. He's so good in the movie, too. Like, he's really great.
But good for you. See, she got involved in the whole story.
Yeah, of course.
Absolutely. Well, let's take a look at a scene now. The Cullens here are throwing Bella a birthday party. Okay? Here we go.
Getting an older woman, huh? What?
You first, Rosalie.
It's a necklace. Alice picked it up.
Thanks.
Show me the love.
This one's from Emmett.
Already installed it in your truck. Finally a decent sound system for that piece
hey,
of crap.
Don't hate the truck. Open his name, Carlaps.
Just a little something to brighten your day.
You seem to be looking kind of pale lately.
Twilight Saga New Moon opens on Friday. Thanks, Christian. Thanks for coming. Good to have you here. Appreciate it.